Kansas City Federal Reserve President Thomas Hanek announced today he'll be stepping down on October 1st. For more on the news and the search for a successor, let's bring in Dr. Donald Ratajczak. He's the chief consulting economist at Morgan Keegan, and he used to run the Georgia State Economic Forecasting Center, which is considered to be one of the most reliable and accessible sources for economic information. He joins us on the phone from Atlanta. Dr. Ratajczak, welcome back to Bottom Line. Always good to have you on.
Thank you.
Sir, for Mr. Hanek, 8 straight dissents. How important was his voice of dissent?
Well, I think it was important in two ways. He certainly was the senior member of the Open Market Committee when he was dissenting. And he's also coming from farm country, from agriculture. And basically, he's not seeing the problem that Bernanke is seeing. His banks don't look that bad. There are asset price increases in the agricultural belt. So basically, from where he's coming from, also his seniority, it led him to say, slow down. Things are looking good in the agricultural sector. I can't believe they're that bad everywhere else.
How does Mr. Hanek's announced retirement affect the hawk-dove balance at the Fed?
Well, I don't think anyone has as much courage to dissent as he does.
Why do you say that, sir?
Basically, he was the senior member 4 decades in the Federal Reserve system. No one else had that degree of background and 2 decades as the president of the Federal Reserve. Now, you have some other potential dissenters in Fisher and Blosser who are currently on the Open Market Committee. And Lacker, when he becomes on the Open Market Committee, but they clearly are newbies. They're not as willing to dissent openly.
Mm-hmm. Well, what does this mean now in terms of an exit strategy for quantitative easing? Does it affect that at all?
My guess is that we're not going to have a problem after the $600 billion is done. We're going to do the $600 billion, but after it's done, I doubt that there could be a vote for anything further. However, they will wait several months after that, I believe, before they will start to raise interest rates.
You mentioned Mr. Plosser and Mr. Fisher. With Mr. Hanek now stepping down, what might their roles be? Will they be a little bit more in the limelight? And secondarily, I might ask you the news that we received yesterday about Mr. Bernanke going to hold press conferences online. I'd like to get your thoughts on both of those issues.
Well, first of all, I mean, it'll be up to Fisher and Plosser to decide whether they want to take that dissenting conscience that Hanek, he was unique because of his long-term stature, and these guys are not that unique there. Will they take up the mantle, or will they just want to dissent in the discussion but not in the vote? Which apparently is what they're doing now.
And if I might ask you quickly, before we get to Mr. Bernanke, any likely successors come to mind for Mr. Hanek?
I have no idea who they're looking at in Kansas, although it is possible that you can get another Hanek, but not with the pedigree.
And Dr. Ratajczak, in our final 30 seconds, that news we heard yesterday about the press conferences by Mr. Bernanke, your thoughts?
Well, of course, he's trying to offset what is really a significant amount of criticism about QE2. And the criticism is mounting as more central banks around the world are thinking about raising rates. Right. We're going to be the outlier. And you have to have good arguments for being an outlier, especially when your economy is growing at trend rates of growth now.
Dr. Donald Ratajczak, Chief Consulting Economist, Morgan Keegan, joining us on the phone from Atlanta. Sir, thanks so much. We appreciate it.
You're welcome.